Have a seat. I'm going to show you something with the trigger stick here. I haven't done too much with that yet. That's hard to believe. Just trying out these rifles. Oh, I wish I could get that to sit still for a minute. On this monopod leg trigger stick, they got about 1, 2, and 3 legs. Pull the trigger, get it where you want it, let go. I've got this on the third one, or not sure, but this thing is like 10, 12 pounds with the scope in it. It's one big, nasty, heavy son of a gun. I was on the third notch already, too. I'm trying to get it, find a notch to put the thing on. Where I can get it to float, get the rifle to float on that rubber band. I think that was the intention. Didn't see them there. That thing is so heavy. I could set that all the way up, and it's just gonna. I think with the recoil, it can bend around a little bit. Mention anything all straight up and down and stuff where it's, you're not reaching your head farther forward to for eye clearance, which is a lot harder than it looks. I got the monopod leg because it'll fit a golf club tube made into a scabbard on my walker. You use two legs and you couldn't find a tube big enough diameter wise. You can hold pretty still though, so you know, that's pretty good. Okay. So the fourth notch, this one can just, it can kind of move back and forth a little bit with the band right there, because it just, that thing is, this thing is so damn heavy, it's just, you can't. That's a pain to get between the desk and everything to get back in here too. Can't figure out why in the world something is. I'm not kidding. I can't get that gun back in the notch. It won't go. Let me work one hand here. There. Okay. That was the Benjamin 25 Magnum. Here is the Winchester 177 Magnum. Okay, this one wants to float just a hair more. Oh. It's not gonna work. These guns are just weighing 25 jungle tons on a rubber band that's not heavy enough. The other night when I was sleeping, got underneath everything and I was trying to dry everything out. Okay. Wait. Let's put it on the last notch and see if that does anything. Fuck off, telephone. Oh, I broke it. I broke the band. Now I gotta see if I can find another one. I literally pulled that band in half on one side where the little holes are, trying to get that dumb thing tight. Got it on the absolute last notch. I can't get it any tighter. Easy to find a space like in here to put that in and to get this the bottom of this thing close enough to you and everything where it's easy to steady yourself so you can use your get the proper eye spacing comfortably enough. Once you kind of start getting used to it, that I guess it'd be fine. And this one broke one of the scope stop screws off right there. So I don't know. I swear I don't. I need to fix it, and that's all I know. I just plain gotta fix it. See, this one's lighter. This is like 8.6 pounds, something like that, with scope and all. And it could actually kind of float a little bit on that there rubber band. I've never seen any more of these bands. I'm going to have to see if you can buy extra ones somewhere. This is a really nice shooting rifle. I really want to hunt small game with this thing. It's a wonderful rifle. Great balance, accuracy, not overly pellet picky. You couldn't ask for a nicer rifle. Oh, you can go like that a little bit too. Besides, say I want to shoot up on a tree, and I'm shooting 35, 40 yards, let's say. Well, okay, anyway, that's... And then let's say going back to ground level. I mean, you can hold it like that. And like that. But once you find the right level spot, it is more comfortable on your neck, but it's still a pain in the butt to use this thing. I don't care how many legs you've got. Got to get used to how to position the thing with the rifle, that is to say. And there we go. I love this one. I really love this rifle. Hassan Striker 1000X, the X denoting the Woodstock. 22 caliber. 95, 96. With money off from my particular credit card I've got, and the shipping thing was $108.73 or something like that for Midway USA for this rifle, 2 days flat shipping. So he's using the two day maybe three Pony Express or something. But that a really fantastic group of folks to deal with at MidwayUSA.com. Some of the Amazon sellers like TreadPro are good too. TreadPro is very good for hammer scopes. Oh, I must have been under everything else. let's try it with the 55, 56 variant one, model 160. Let it sit on the action knob there, I guess. Oh, this is a center point 4x32. They say these are junk. Screw them. About 39 bucks, sometimes less, sometimes a little more, depending on where you're going. But it's a really clear fixed power scope for small of these mid-power guns. It's wonderful. I'm getting two more of these for the two 760s I've got. They both have rifle barrels and the Mac 1 seal and piston upgrade, blah, blah, blah. I completely restore modded this one too. So there's two more waiting to get restore modded, and I got a ultra high Kentucky rifle kit back there. I'm in the middle of restoring. Yeah. That's. When you keep your elbows against your rib cage when you're using this thing, that seems to steady it up a lot more. And this is the plex reticle on the center point. It's like the Dual X. It's a modern version of the Dual X on the old Weavers. It's a duplex reticle. But the finer center point of the reticle is smaller overall than some of the other ones. There's the side, not too many people see. Did a really nice job on that. That's a beautiful rifle. Little piece of elm, which sure looks good. Oh. And here is, you can tell this thing really needs piston seal and all that shit. It actually sits up on that rubber band, it's so light. But that'll have Picatinny to it. Two AR-15 2.5-inch Picatinny rails up here that are beveled on both ends, so it follows this angle here for the breech opening is. So you'll still have plenty of room to get your fingers under the scope to put the pellet in, because it is single shot even though it's a bolt action. It cocks when you pump it on this one, but these older ones, the newer ones that don't.
What's that?
Just doing something with my rifle. Unless nobody wants to talk to you until you're busy doing something, especially filming, now they want to bother you. And this is a 760D Pump Master, April 98. This one's 30 years newer than that other one, which is June 68. And this is a Weaver V22A, 3-6x18, 22 scope from the 70s. I bought at Clarkin's, 25 bucks. Somewhere in the 70s, late 70s maybe, I don't know. Something like that. Well, the real steady and the... This thing loves 10 yards, and this scope is nice. It still works perfectly for as old as that thing is. Old as the bloody hills. And yeah, I'd like to run through the hills. And that's as low as it goes. That's about 31 inches. So that was a quickie, just to see how that trigger stick, as it's called, works. Here's the logo, Primos. Primos hunting calls. They make hunting calls. It says to hold it here, that way you don't have to, it'd make noise with all the leaves and cracklings underfoot, and take it like that and place it right, and put the gun there and just see. And it's real tree camo. That's at Walmart, 31 inches to 64 and a half. Shoot up into trees and, you know, whatnot like that, like I showed you. $49.95, $49.97, something like that. And it actually says trigger stick on it right there. So, I just thought I'd show you that one real quick. So, Lord willing, the creeks don't rise. We'll see you again.